And welcome back to Let's Play Life is Strange. Blind. I'm the RPG chick. We are beginning episode 4. Yeah, really curious to see where things go from here because, well, just watch.
Previously on Life is Strange.
Whoa!
You don't know who the fuck I am, or who you're messing around with!
Don't ever touch me again, freak! Let's talk about your superpower. What are you doing here, Max? Stop! Don't come near me!
Not now. It won't work.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us. Miss Caulfield, please, tell us everything.
Hey, it's Thelma and Louise.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
Max, we have to find Rachel soon. Like you said, it's time to start the search for clues.
Excuse me.
Welcome to my domain. Let's find what we want and beat it.
Max, you better come check out these files.
Rachel in the dark room. Over and over. That's it. Listen, I found pictures of Rachel and Frank being more than a friend.
I can't believe she was banging Frank. Rachel straight up lied to my face. Why didn't she say anything?
So who do you most want to blame?
My fucking dad, of course. Hello?
No, you don't.
Do you know what it's like to wait for your father to come home when you're a kid? Ever since he died, my life has been dipped in shit.
Chloe, I am awesome. We are awesome.
Hello, are you even listening, Maxine?
This is totally fucked up. What else have I changed?
Max Caulfield, hold on.
Chloe, you have a visitor.
Yeah. I'm wondering also if the changes are restricted to this town. I mean, who knows? What else is going on elsewhere? Someone else had this power. Or animals dying and weird weather occurring in other regions. Maybe all over the world. I don't know. Chloe's in contact with her parents and they haven't, mention anything. They're in LA, I think. So there's that. But of course now we've altered time from the point at which her father died. So he's not dead and everything's changed. Some things not for the better. And that threw me. That completely floored me. It's still flooring me. Great story. Can't wait to see where this goes. You've yet to see all the ramifications of this. I know it. Although there's already been more than enough ramifications. Episode 4, Dark Room. Yeah, that's Chloe. And those are dead beached whales. Well, they're all cut up too.
It's weird hanging out with you again.
I know. I'm glad we are, though.
It was nice that you sent me actual letters. It's more than any of my other friends have done.
So we've kept in touch this time.
And you even wrote on that cool parchment paper. It's so Max.
So pretentious. But I love writing on it like an English poet. You deserve the best stationery.
Probably easier to write than to visit me. I don't mean that in a bitchy way. Not totally. You probably wanted to avoid awkward conversations like this.
Pretty much, yeah.
Look, the worst thing you can do is treat me like a baby. I still want to laugh and talk shit with my best friend. Can we stop?
Okay, so how'd this happen to you?
This is seriously the best view of the sunset. What do photographers call that?
The golden hour.
See? Without you here, I'd have no clue. Bet you could take some amazing shots.
Lo, are you ignoring dead whales all over the place?
Those beached whales are so sad. I kind of know how they feel. At least, I'm alive here with you.
You're a real survivor, Chloe. I know you have to deal with so much.
I don't want anybody else feeling sorry for me. I can do that. Along with my parents. My dad still feels guilty about buying me that car.
No. So instead of him getting into an accident picking up his wife, her mother, he got her car and she got an accident? Want to talk about the accident?
Are you okay to talk about the accident?
We never actually have, huh? There's not much to say. Some prick in an SUV cut me off and I flew into a ditch.
Do you remember everything?
I saw everything in bullet time. I felt my back snap and...
Ugh.
And that was the last thing I ever felt in my body.
Oh, God.
When I woke up in the hospital, I literally couldn't move a muscle.
Jesus.
Ugh.
I don't know what to say.
Don't say anything. I'm just happy I did get to see you again. I could have ended up vanishing out of the blue like that girl from Blackwell.
Did she even meet Rachel as a result? What missing girl?
What missing girl?
I don't know her name. I just read about it in the news.
Excuse me, like Rachel who?
I feel bad for her family.
This is such a different world than when we were kids, isn't it?
After that snow and eclipse, it's more like the end of the world.
You think?
Do you think so? I haven't kept up with the details.
I have more time on my hands than you. Plus, I'm a science nerd. But none of this makes sense.
I know things seem out of control, but as long as we're together, I don't feel afraid.
Hanging out with you makes me feel like a total kid again. You don't even know.
Listen, Chloe, I'm sorry I haven't been out to see you more. That was wrong.
At least we kept in touch.
You're my best friend.
Max, thanks for coming out to see me. You're doing awesome.
I don't think so.
My nose is getting cold. Maybe we should get back to my place?
It is hella cold out here.
Hella? I hate that word, no offense.
Kidding me?
None taken.
The other Chloe always said hella. She is way different and not just as far as handicapped. I guess she never turned into her, you know, rebellious ways. How can you be rebellious stuck in a wheelchair, though? I don't know. I don't think I prefer this timeline. I don't know if we can change it back.
Pretty high-tech lair.
Feels like a high-tech cell. But I am lucky my parents bust their ass to take care of me. I know it's hard for them.
They're grateful you're here with them.
Right. Especially when they can't even take a walk alone. Sometimes I act like a total teenage brat just to give them an excuse to yell at me. Pathetic, I know.
Chloe, you're a great daughter. You're kind and sensitive, when you don't even have to be.
Trust me, I still get my rage on. Especially when a nurse has to watch while I take a dump so she can wipe my bum. Or when doctors flip me around like I was a science doll.
Mm. I can't even imagine. But you're still amazing. You always have been since we were kids.
Thanks again for coming, Max. I need to get my drink on. Can you bring me some water?
Yeah, water. Not beer. Oh my god. So we get to see all the differences in Chloe's room. Is this even the same room? Yeah, I believe it is. The bed was here. The night table and all the stuff were here. She had a table here in the middle, right? Bathroom. You know, I'm not sure if it is the same room. Because the closet was here. We have a door instead. Bathroom. Yeah, there was no attached bathroom. Did she move into her parents' room? Maybe they switched rooms?
That's a serious heat lamp.
Oh, it's a heat lamp. To keep her warm.
Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now.
Oh my god. I can't even imagine, guys. I got the willies just from this whole thing because that's really one of my greatest fears is becoming paralyzed like that from the neck down or even worse. Not being able to feel anything, not being able to move. It's like claustrophobia in your own body. Which I also have a little minor claustrophobia thing going on, so it's all connected.
I'm glad I took this photo. Chloe has a new memory of William and her together.
I mean, I know nobody really wants that to happen, but I actively think about it sometimes and get afraid. My wonderful mind. What would it be like if I couldn't move? Thanks, brain!
At least Chloe doesn't weigh that much.
Yeah, really. She's skinnier, right? Think so.
Oh man. She has to use that ventilator just to breathe.
How did she make do when we were walking around on the beach? Is this some sort of portable version that works for a little while?
Hello, Chloe. She likes fluffy animals now.
I know, she's so much more of a good girl.
Oh, the snow dough. I guess not everything changed.
The one we broke by mistake in the box up top and we had to rewind to fix it.
Snow globes are taking over.
Mm-hmm. Or rewind to make ourselves not have done it.
That must be her mighty morphine machine. No more bongs for her. I still can't believe I put Chloe in that chair.
Oh my god. So the difference is now we're responsible. We weren't responsible for what happened to her father.
Chloe's message board since the accident sure looks lonely. I didn't add much. So cool that you're here again. Bad man.
I'm glad you think so.
Glad you think so what?
It's nice my parents sent a card at least.
Chloe, you know we love you and you're in our hearts and thoughts. We hope to see your smiling face soon. Please be well. Ryan and Vanessa Caulfield. Same address, right? 44 Cedar?
I wonder who this is. Kind of a generic card.
Megan? Dear Chloe, I am so sorry for what happened. Know that I am here for you if you need anything. I hope you feel better, and I hope to see you again.
I wasn't very available to Chloe. Real nice.
Chloe, just thought I'd drop you a quick note to let you know I'm thinking about you. I feel so lame writing shit like, I hope you are well, etc. I know your life is so different now, and I don't want that to get in the way of our friendship. Yes, I haven't been around lately, but that will change soon. Quote unquote, I hope you are well. Love, Max.
At least I sent road trip selfies to Chloe. I'm sure that made her feel great. Man, Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe. They're so great.
Maybe it is the same room and they just added on somehow, I don't know.
There's the old Chloe.
We're horrible. Oh, I was wondering about that. You know, I gotta say something about that for a second. We're really horrible, not giving her her water. We're almost done, though.
I should offer to put makeup on for Chloe. Not that I can, but it would be fun.
Why can't you?
You're really my only friend who kept in touch.
I should have kept more in touch.
So, mouth control joystick. There is this guy on Twitch, I believe. He plays MOBA games and MMORPGs, and basically, yeah, he's completely immobile, and he uses a mouth-controlled joystick to move his character around and do, you know, cast spells or abilities, what have you. Really awesome. Awesome guy. You know, I mean, I don't know him personally, but I've watched some of his videos. Couldn't tell you who it is. Maybe, if I remember, I'll put a, you know, his username or something like that.
Whoa, Chloe can totally control her computer. It's so great people get this high-tech help.
I can't imagine how much that stuff costs, though, seriously. I mean, maybe it's paid for by some kind of program, but still.
That is so incredible. And she can browse cat videos on the web.
Cat videos.
Chloe is still a punk at heart. But she can't stage dive anymore.
Did she ever stage dive? Did she grow up without stage diving? The Black Attic Club. Black Flag Tribute Band. Dorothy Twister. Lopan's Eyes. Pisshead. The Disco Boys. Groovy Ghoulies. Oh, for Halloween night. Right. And so episode one. Let me just write a little note for myself. Twitch guy. Let's try to find him.
That's so cool that Chloe has made friends online.
Did I say episode 4? Episode 4, part 1. Welcome to Hot Wheels chat room. For your safety, do not give any personal information to any person in this chat room. You are responsible for knowing the chat room rules. Miss Blue says, so what are you doing? Miss Blue, I bet you that's Chloe. She loves the color blue. She doesn't have blue hair right now, but she still loves it. Ignatius says, Miss Blue says, what are you doing? Ignatius says, talking with you. Haha, no shit. I'm about to binge on Quantum Leap. OMG, love, Scott Bakula rules. So do you. I hope we can meet soon. Not if you're in San Francisco. Hey, I have to take care of some body work. Let me get back to you while you're bringing on Bakula. Ignatius says, you better. He says, hello? Alright, we looked at everything.
Glad to see you're as nosy as ever.
I don't want to disappoint you.
But of course not.
Instead of handing Chloe a bong, I'm feeding her water. Did I give her a choice?
Drink up, Buttercup.
Oh, man. No wonder my throat is dry. I don't think I've talked this much the whole year.
Have you ever thought about doing a podcast or something?
I wish I could punch your face right now. A podcast? Dude, I am a pod in a cast. Boring.
Ouch. It was just a thought.
I know you're just trying to help.
Yeah, that's become a bad habit of mine.
A vlog, then.
You sound like an adult now. It seems like we were kids in another life.
What do you remember?
What do you remember about us as kids? We all have different memories.
I think about us as little pirates, running and jumping through Arcadia Bay.
Me too. But we're still pirates in our own way.
Yeah, right. Check me out, Chloe of the Caribbean. No way will I get on a fucking boat now. Unless you're with me. As you can see, I can't keep all my other friends away.
Which friends? Obviously not many. I don't want to dig in like that. You have me.
You have me. I'm not leaving you, Chloe.
Well, you didn't visit me a lot either. I mean, I loved your cards and photos, but...
I know I wasn't around much. No excuses, I'm a loser. But I am trying to make things right.
How? Dude, you're not Supermax. And I'm not trying to guilt trip you. That's what my parents are for.
Why'd they guilt trip her? They love you.
They love you so much.
I know. My mom and dad are so cute. They always pop in here and make sure everything's okay with me.
I think Joyce and William are incredible.
Max, the accident has been so hard on them. Our insurance sucks, and the medical bills are fucking insane.
Can they pay it?
Can they pay all the bills?
No way. They keep the numbers away from me, but it doesn't take much research to find out I'm costing my parents almost $1 million a year.
Chloe.
Damn.
You're priceless. No pun intended.
You're such a geek. That's why I love you. Of course, I know a geek when I be one. See, I'm practically a human entertainment system. It would be sweet to chill out together and watch a movie like when you'd spend the night at my house.
What do you want to watch?
I think I'm in like a mellow Blade Runner mood.
Cool.
I always cry at the end.
Plus,
you know I always wanted to have cool colored bangs like Pris.
I know. You would look incredible with blue hair.
She does.
Let's get this show on the road. And you better not fall asleep on me like you always do when we watch movies.
I remember, Max. Swear I won't fall asleep. Not when you're here. Not yet.
The hell did that mean? So what happens? Do they cut her off the medical at some point? Well, maybe because they're paying some of it. So now we have more options, stuff to look at. Anything else I can look at over here? No. No. We got drawer, DVD player.
So here's the DVD player. Now I just need to find the DVD.
How right you are.
Oh my god. I made that mix for her when we were 12.
Pirate power. Okay, guess it's in the other drawer.
Here's the DVD.
Ha ha. It's actually a really great movie. Really old, but really awesome. Harrison Ford. What if this is actual audio from the movie? Hmm. Watch me get a copyright claim for Blade Runner theme or something. Yeah, doubt it. You never know, though, sometimes. We stayed all night? She's still up, or she woke up? I thought we were laying on her legs.
I cannot believe you fell asleep so fast. How dare you?
Oops.
I know you were beat down after the day with me. And Blade Runner is a pretty dreamy movie to watch at night. Do you think Deckard is a replicant? Sorry, I can see you're not wide awake like me.
No, I'm sorry I crashed so hard. Were you okay?
I do have a mother and father when you're not falling asleep on me.
You are a bitch in the morning.
It's the company I keep. Yesterday was such a blast.
It was great seeing you.
I know things were different when we were just dorky kids, but being with you made me feel like when we were little pirates, jumping and running through the forests again.
Aww.
It meant a lot to me just to chill out with you and bullshit.
That's awesome.
Fuck. I'm getting my regular head pains. Can you pretty please go upstairs and get my morphine injector in the bathroom?
Morphine injector?
It's total Star Trek shit. You can't even see the needle. Seriously, I need it. My parents keep this wag upstairs because they think I can't get to it. But you can, Max. Like a pirate, right?
I'm on it, Chloe.
Morphine injector. What if we look in here now? She just opens and closes it.
Oh my god, I made that mix for her when we were 12. Does Chloe look at the garden and think about her childhood? She can't even feel the grass now.
Oh, we got these drawers now. I guess we could also have looked in here for the DVDs.
Wowzer. Chloe was a straight A student. She could have gone to any college.
Yup.
What a bastard. I totally should have let Chloe steal your bullshit fund.
What?
Even if it wasn't another reality.
From Principal Wells, 8th of August, 2011. Dear Mr. and Mrs. Price, as principal, I am in sympathy with your numerous requests for Chloe's special needs in regards to her wheelchair and class accessibility, etc. Blackwell prides itself on making sure students with disabilities receive full compliance under the Americans with Disabilities Act. However, given that the campus and buildings have all been constructed pre-1977, our school has not yet undergone the modern renovations necessary to fulfill all the needs of your daughter and her regrettable condition. Sadly, with recent deplorable federal cuts in education, it will take many more fundraisers to fully update Blackwell Academy. But that day will come. Chloe is without a doubt an amazing student with great potential, despite her handicap, and I believe she would find a more fitting, rewarding scholastic environment at the H. West Miskatonic Institute in Boston. They have a rich legacy of disabled graduates, and I know that Chloe would achieve her usual academic leadership in more comfortable surroundings. With her outstanding GPA, there is no doubt that Miskatonic would welcome Chloe with open halls. I hope you will seriously consider this suggestion, as I'm sure your daughter would prefer to attend a school that could cater to her many needs. Excuse me. In the same spirit, I've also enclosed brochures for any potential schools in the Oregon region. If you have any questions, please contact my office. Well, I guess they can't They don't have the funds to put it in. What can they do? Budget sucks.
I'm so glad we had our movie night. Even if you crashed on me.
That's why they call it a sleepover.
I thought Chloe fell asleep first. Oh, this drawer.
Nothing but medical supplies. She has to use a lot of lotion to keep her blood circulating.
God.
There's the old Chloe.
So, are you sure it isn't too weird for you to be hanging out with me like this?
No way.
No way. I don't want you to feel weird.
My life is just so different than yours. I mean, you can't just bounce out of here and I'll be doped up half the day in pain. So that's cool. But I do feel grateful I can see the ocean. That I have parents who love me. And that my best friend is here with me today.
Exactly. So, what else do you need?
Well, hot monkey sex would be nice.
What?
Oh, look. I made Maxine blush. So, are you dating anyone at Blackwell?
I have no idea what we're doing at Blackwell. Apparently we're in the Vortex Club, so I have no idea what's going on.
Not really. No. There are some cute boys there, but you know me. I'm too damn shy.
Which is stupid, because you're so damn cool. Some bro has to be crushing on you.
I was supposed to go out with this guy named Warren, but I don't think he's into me anymore.
His loss. You need to move on, girl. Plenty of fish in the bay. Shit. I sound like my dad.
Warren, huh? How is William?
How is William? Do you like having him around?
Of course. He's my hero. I swear he would do anything for me or Mom. Wish I could do something for him.
You have. You're here with your family.
More like they're here for me. But then so are you. So it's all good.
Well, it's not even in here. Oh.
Man, Joyce and William built a whole new bathroom for Chloe. They're so great.